Mike Williams Jr. has been pumping up NFL fans with his Monday Night Football theme song for 20 years. Until tonight, ESPN pulled the song from their broadcast after Hank went on Fox and Friends and said this about President Obama.
You remember the golf game they had, ladies and gentlemen?
You mean when John Boehner played golf with President Obama?
Oh, yeah, yeah. And Biden and Kasich, yeah. Uh-huh.
What did you not like about it? It seems to be a really pivotal moment for you.
Come on, come on. It'd be like Hitler playing golf with Netanyahu, okay?
Comparing President Obama to Hitler was even too much for the kids on Fox and Friends, and they challenged Hank on it, but he just doubled down.
Yeah, I don't understand that analogy, actually.
Well, it's
I'm glad you don't, brother, because a lot of people do. Well, you know, they're the enemy. They're the enemy.
Who's the enemy?
Obama and Biden. Are you kidding? The Three Stooges.
That's only
the
two.
You use the name of one of the most hated people in all of the world to describe the president, which...
Yeah, that is true, but I'm telling you like it is.
Tell it like it is. Gretchen Carlson went on to disavow Hank's analogy, but these guys should have known what they were getting into. You see, Hank Williams Jr. is no stranger to offensive right-wing politics. He performed at Sarah Palin's campaign events in 2008, playing along with her palling around with terrorists line.
John and Sarah tell you just what they think, and they're not gonna blink, and they don't have terrorist friends to whom their careers are linked.
Well, I applaud ESPN for yanking Hank's theme song from Monday Night Football. TPRers have been carrying Hitler signs for years, and Republicans have done nothing but make excuses for them. Finally, one of these guys has to face some consequences for this unacceptable behavior and approach. I'm joined tonight by Mike Papantonio, host of the Ring of Fire radio show. A couple of hours ago, Hank Williams Jr. responded with this statement, Mike. Some of us have strong opinions and are often misunderstood. My analogy was extreme, but it was to make a point. Every time the media brings up the Tea Party, it's painted as a racist and extremist, but there's never a backlash, no outrage to those comparisons. Working class people are hurting, and it doesn't seem like anybody cares when both sides are high-fiving it on the ninth hole, when everybody else is without a job. It makes a whole lot of us angry. Something has to change, he says. The politics have to change. Well, it would seem to me, based on that statement right there, Mike, that this guy ought to be supporting President Obama's jobs plan. What do you think?
Ed, it used to be when a washed-up has-been celebrity stopped selling music or making movies, or when they became completely irrelevant, they had a place to go. They could show up for Hollywood Squares, or maybe they could show up for Pat Robertson's 700 Club. Nowadays, they show up on Fox, or they become part of this neo-nut personality, and they give speeches at places like these cuckoo gatherings at GPAC or Tea Party conventions. When you haven't written a song anybody can hum or even remember for two decades, like Hank Williams, you do what Hank Williams does. He tries to find this small, crazy niche where people still might remember his name. Hank saw Ted Nugent do that. He saw Ted Nugent do that with the RA. He saw John Voight and Dennis Miller struggle to get some relevance when they tried to latch onto these oddball conservative groups. Look, Hank has always understood that he's never going to be nearly as talented or as famous as his father, and he's never going to be remembered as that timeless talent. So what he's done is he's latched on. He's tried to kick the drugs. He's tried to kick the alcohol. If you just watch that interview, you're pretty sure he hasn't done it. Look, the old boy is really so lonesome he could cry, because the Tea Party is the last crowd. It's the last bunch of people paying attention to him. It's a sad story. Now they've jerked his song off from Monday Night Football, for God's sakes.
Well, for a week, I don't know how long it's going to go, but here's ESPN statement. While Frank Williams Jr. is not an ESPN employee, we recognize that he is closely linked to our company through the open of Monday Night Football. We are extremely disappointed with his comments, and as a result, we have decided to pull the open from tonight's telecast. What about future telecasts? I mean, a lot of times when people make comments like this, it'll deep six their career. And I can show you a list of those folks. And why has it taken so long for someone to face consequences for this kind of rhetoric? What do you make of it?
Ed, you see, that interview, as you watched him, even the crowd at Fox and Friends, as kooky as they are, they even saw a nut job who now represents, honest to God, represents the Republican Party. So when you have the Fox and Friends saying they're stepping back from a guy like this, the reason they're stepping back is they understand that the Hank Williams Jr. type nuts are in charge of the Republican Tea Party.
But he says President Obama, you attack President Obama saying that he is the enemy and compared him to probably the world's worst human being ever who tried to wipe out a race of people.
I mean, yeah, and he was selling, Ed, he was selling to the same people who held up pictures of Obama as Hitler, who held up pictures as Obama as little black Sambo, and this is the crowd that he's appealing to. And what I'm trying to say here, Ed, when Fox and Friends understands that Hank Williams is a risk to the Republican Party, that's why they started backing away, not because they didn't, you know, a couple of them I can promise you agreed with him, but they started backing away because they understand the Republican Party is imploding because of the Hank Williams Jr. characters that are in charge of what's going on in those politics. He is a washed up, a has-been celebrity, and really this is his last big stand, Ed. That's what's so sad and pathetic about this story.
Is this a turning point for the Tea Partiers at all when it comes to ripping into President Obama and making these outrageous comparisons, or will it just be more of the same?
Well, they have to stay on this route, Ed. They have to stay on the route because when you take a look at the polls, you look at the people who have really tried to understand who the Tea Party is. Racism is one of the key issues that drives that party. Look, it's not me talking. It's virtually every poll that they've taken. That underlying current of racism is there. So they can't get away from it.
Yeah.
It's the last chance the Republicans have to stay alive. It's a pathetic state of affairs for the Republican Party because Tea Party and Republican Party are synonymous these days.
Mike Papantonio, great to have you with us tonight. Always look forward to your take. Thank you.